we'll have to see if IG's unconventional, in quotation marks, draft is gonna win.
At all.
High ping excuse, don't worry about it. Exorcism pop.
Bro strike.
It just gets caught without morphing up.
They just catch Firefly.
Yeah, that's the only problem I have with his morphling here. He is very hit or miss on the hero. Sometimes he owns incredibly hard. Nice cut down from a tree. Beer.
Yeah, following that up with a spear, so a lot of stun time with the arrow. Really well done by JT. But there's not much defense he can really make out of it. They've got the Hex coming in from Kaka. Icarus dive over. That's on a JT as well as Emo. Burrow strike not too far away, and he's stunned up once again. And this is going to be Faith Beyond going down. IG, the farm that they need to really enable themselves.
Yeah. Oh, good Hex here. Canceling the
They've
dive.
Got the stun to follow it up. They'll have a spear onto the lonesome tree that's in the river. God's Rebuke finish for JT. He's got yet another now sitting 3-0-2, so he's on a killing spree.
Oh, Manta style after that. Putting forward.
Burrow strike comes in. That's going to land onto Emo. They've got the silence to follow it up. Crypt Swarm's there. Can they get the kill on the Mirana? Yule's up into the air. They've got 4 heroes here. Exorcism, Supernova.
Get him.
Committed leaps away. Emo! Oh my god, and they got Ame while all this is happening! Just leap away.
Three times.
You didn't get a kill, you just got a tower. Yes, that opens up their side of the jungle, but that's not going to go that great. Now they've got themselves the arena as well as the Ice Blast coming in. The Yule sets it up, and look at that. Just hopped up into the air, into the wall as he gets hit by that Earth Spike and the Spear. Really, the only guy in the region who is making that hero work is if you see a blink in, they've got the Ice Blast. Ame caught again. Ice Blast is going to land onto Ame. The Burrow Strike hits on it too, but that's just maybe giving up Faith Beyond's life. Finger comes through. They get a second. They'll land a stun onto two more, but they do end up trading off Emo. They go into the Moonlight Shadow. They're trying to run, but they've got the vision. They're ready to go. The Exorcism running. Mars in trouble. Cold Fiend and a spear. We'll make sure that Nothing to Say is held back and will freeze over. So they cannot chase this Mars, but they do find the Hex onto the Ancient Apparition as he's TPing out. So Ollie, he's caught, and he's killed.
Ame, just be careful here.
He's in trouble. He's going to die here. They've got the Earth Spike. They'll land the arrow. No, it's going to be blocked, but
hey,
it should still have the control and an Ice Blast. Ame dead again. You can see IG just pushing down the Tier 2 bottom, and they're going to smoke. They really want to find something. They know that they're ahead, and if they can shut down Ame continuously, they'll be real happy with this. As they find themselves
again.
Ame, they've got the arena, and again, there's the Ice Blast. With the spear, they'll use the finger. They'll get the kill.
They can't really find any pickoffs themselves, despite having Blink Dagger on the Sand King. And not a pickoff.
Yeah. Doesn't get hexed, doesn't get caught.
Epicenter, one nice.
Burrow Strike landing on a two. This could
no
set
damage.
Up to be something nice for them, but they just don't get the kill on Emo just yet. They've got themselves the spear that lands, and Faith Beyond, he's in trouble, but they get the kill on Emo, and Faith Beyond gets the Burrow Strike out onto the Mars. JT with the God's Rebuke will finish him off, but they've got the signs coming in for Nothing to Say. That will be three for both sides overall.
That he's foregoing it is interesting.
Smoke. They're going to try and make a move here. Burrow Strike hits onto Ollie. They're going to get the silence out of two of these heroes. They're looking over at the Ancient Apparition with the Sunray right on top of him, melting the ice of this AA. They'll get the kill on Ollie, and they'll look over at Kaka, who lands a two-man Earth Spike. It was Exorcism used, and they've got the Moonlight Shadow trying to run, but the Balance Strike will be the finish. Two kills there for LGD.
Wow, amazing analysis work. Maybe we'll switch roles next game.
Oh, you flatter me.
I'm caught out again.
Yeah, but the
blast
comes out. They've got the Ice Blast coming through. That's going to land onto Jinkyu. They'll get the kill onto the Shadow Shaman.
It's going to be pretty damn hard. Oh.
Burrow Strike.
Kaka.
They've got the Hex. Kaka in the right position. Sunray trying to keep him alive.
Disc again.
And this is going to pop once again. Burrow Strike finger. Ice Blast coming in. Flyfly gets the kill onto Faith Beyond. They'll take it to the Sand King once again. And now Innocence on the run, but the waveform, like I said, they can really cut down the gaps between them and these heroes. But got the supernova going off, and I don't know if they're going to be able to pop this. They'll throw the spear that lands onto Nothing to Say. They'll get the kill to the Death Prophet. The supernova's going to go off, and JT's going to be stunned up, locked down, and killed off. JT falls, Ollie to follow suit. Jinkyu gets the kill there. Serpent Wards are down, but the Burrow Strike comes out from Firefly onto the Shadow Shaman. They've got themselves the Earth Spike to finish off Jinkyu. They'll get yet another kill. The arrow will just miss Faith Beyond. If LGD can find a good fight here, it might set them up to get the next Aegis. They're going to go Blink, Burrow Strike, Exorcism all used. They've got the Shackles onto the Mirana. They'll catch Emo.
Good and fortunate timing here for IG that Roche doesn't respawn any faster.
And just proc'd once again. They're going to get the Supernova off. They had a Burrow Strike. Balance Strike missing as he waveforms away. But now Spear, that's a complete whiff with the BKB. Popeye, nothing to say, going after Kaka. The damage with the Exorcism running down this Lion. They pop the Lincolns. They've got the Hex on a JT. They followed him up, and they should be able to get the kill into the Mars. They will take out JT. Oh, just missing Ollie as he TPs out.
Don't you worry.
They're going to go after this Sand King once again. Ice Blast coming through. Yule's up into the air. The Ice Blast is going to land. They get the kill with BKB's beam. Popeye Flyfly as well. As nothing to say. Who's Aeon Disc will pop. Who try to TP out. Oh, going down right before the TP goes off.
Yeah. I love seeing those numbers go up and down.
Oh, they found the Morphling. They've got themselves the Burrow Strike. He's done it. Got a lot of health to work with anymore. And he is gone for the first time. Only working with 2,200 health on that point. But they've got themselves the Arena as well as the Finger. The Earth Spike is going to land on two of these heroes. They've got the Ice Blast following it up with the Andis Beam popping to the Sand King. They've got the Supernova popped. They'll get the kill on Ami. They've taken it to the Monkey King as well as the Phoenix. They'll look over Fifion. They've got themselves the third. Three heroes gone on the side of LGT. Just like that, they turned it around. They had the luxury of the Aegis, and they will use that luxury to get three kills and come out on top.
He's in danger of always getting blown up. Oh, Emo in position here with the Invis Rune.
There's the Arena. And Ame, he's been caught by the Earth Spike, but they've got the Shackle coming through from Jinkyu. Icarus dive trying to get back into the fight, but they've got the stun on Ame. They need to be careful because he just bought back. The damage coming in with the Star Storm is going to be able to survive this. They've got the Epicenter going from Beef Beyond. They're going to look over at Emo, who's got the BKB running for a couple more seconds. The Aeon Disc is popped on, nothing to say, but they've got the stun now onto the Murana. The waveform forward, they get the kill on Jinkyu. They look over as the Supernova is going to pop right onto the Murana as well as this Morphling. They get the kill on Emo, and now Beef Beyond trying to close the gap. Fly Fly, Ollie, both here. Link is popped, but he's going to morph into the Sand King. Finger onto the Sand King. Spear is lands. They get the kill to Faith Beyond. The Andisk is going to be popped on the Lion. They look over as they land the Shackle. They've got the Silence. He's out of mana, out of time, on the running dead. Ame gets the kill on Akaka, and they will take out two. It is back and forth once again. Ice Blast is it perfectly placed with that E-Blade. It will hit onto the Phoenix. We'll see if he shatters. Percentages, it's aiming towards him surviving.
The last tick.
He's fine.
They're kind of crumbling under the pressure. Oh, the good
arrow hits onto the Phoenix. They're going to follow this up. They've got the Earth Spike as well as the Spear that's going to land on the Phoenix. Can he get himself a Supernova off? No, he can't, but he does have buyback, and they've got themselves an outpost right there. But they
can
go to they're going to end up getting themselves as a second. Shadow Shaman's gone for 85 seconds without buyback, and they're going to use that Wukong's command, but it gets them nothing. They've got the Burrow Strike on the Ollie. They'll look over the Ancient Apparition. They'll at least find one. But again, everything, the kitchen sink, the next door neighbor's entire house, it's all thrown from LGD, and all they get from it is just an Ancient Apparition. They were forced to buy back on the Phoenix, and now they're going to look over at the Lion. They've got themselves the Silence as well as the Hex. They caught themselves Kaka. They hit the Burrow Strike. They'll get the kill, and that's something to work with. Morphling trying to get out of here as he'll TP with the waveform. Fly. He's gone.
Oh, the Phoenix here.
Again caught, and they've got the arrows. He's going to go immediately to the Supernova, but they've got the right clicks. There's no way this goes off. He's dead for 90. He's used Supernova.
Why? Definitely feeling the pressure here that IG is putting on them. Mirana ult once more.
Oh, they caught themselves Faith Beyond. This could be another casualty. They get the kill on Faith Beyond. He's going to buy back with the Aeon just being procced on. Nothing to say. BKBs have gone off. They get the kill there on a Jinkyu. Three heroes gone on the side of LGD, but they've got Sand King coming back in. Morphling, he's just out of here and onto the high ground looking for the Burrow Strike to hit onto Faith Beyond. He won't land it. And
but Ama's not even there. He's not
for
close.
A second. Yeah, he's not there, and the Aegis is going to go in hands of Flyfly once again. They look over at Ollie to try and get a kill into the Ancient Apparition. He's going to be dead for 65 seconds. We'll see if he buys back, and that's exactly what he's going to do. They get the kill into Faith Beyond. They'll take the Sand King for 105. Supernova again.
This fight's going to be 4v5.
He sold the Aeon Disc, and he went right into the
big spear!
Oh, the spear! It lands! Ame! Aeon Disc might have been the right choice, because you are gone, my friend! That's going to be Monkey King gone for 2 minutes. All they do is pop the Aegis. This is not looking good for LGD, and looking so swell for IG. They will take out Jinkyu, take out nothing to say. Four heroes gone. We expect the letters, and there
GG!
It is. Full team wipe and a GG call. IG take game one
nice.
Over LGD.
Wow, and making it look relatively easy. Profit's not one
yeah.
of them.
They're going to try and go in on the Alchemist already here. They've got the homing missile coming through. Kaka moving forward with the help of Flyfly. And they are right on top of the Alchemist. Blade Fury doing a lot of damage. Can he back away? They've got the tag team slowing him up. They'll get the first blood. Ollie gets credit for that, but they lose Flyfly.
Briefcase
that is
damage.
Not the trade you want to be making. And Kaka will deny himself to Roche. Briefcases and documents hurt, man. They're going to charge up the stun. They've got the shackle in the acid spray, and they should have this kill on the Flyfly, and they will. Low bar for him to raise at the moment, and they'll get the kill on the JT. Innocence gets credit for that. They've used the Dream Coil over mid, but they've got the shackle as well as the spear. That comes out onto the puck. Nothing to say. Coming over, and we'll get the kill on to Emo. And now they're looking for more. GQ surviving. Can he get out of this one? He goes onto the high ground, and they're going to run away. They can't go after the Shadow Shaman.
Spear in one.
Oh, dear. Spear, he just wants to land it on something. He might even chase until he can find a spot.
No coil for 5 seconds yet.
They have found themselves the Elder Titan. Four heroes around him, so Innocence will fall to Emo. As they just don't feel like they can fight this out 1v1.
Coil?
They're going to bring over another one. They've got the Dream Coil down from Emo. He's still surviving.
Where's the damage,
they're going to do rotations, and that's exactly what they're going to get. Now they'll look for the sweep, which won't land on either of these heroes, but they brought on it up towards the top lane, and they're going to go after this puck. They'll use the battle trance. The silence a little bit too late. Not a lot of mana to work with. Kaka drops to nothing to say. They've got the stun charged up, which will be avoided. However, Emo's still dead.
Puck just TP's in at level 7. Coils him. Nobody have enough damage. Alchemist, though.
Oh,
hold
right
up in three.
Into this. This is
two.
Not where he wants to be. Can he survive it? They've got the Sprout. He'll use that ult. He'll try to run, but he's blocked in via the treant. And
bye-bye,
catch themselves out.
F and Chet.
Snowball coming through, and they're going to use the Omni Slash. Go on, Faith Beyond. Get the kill for the turnaround. Does Ami have anything to show for this? They'll at least get the gyro. One more shot needed, and he'll finish him off. Ollie dead. Kaka with the TP out. Dream Coil committed. It's only a one for one.
Yeah, I mean, LGD is definitely in the driver's seat right now. Puck has Blink Dagger going in bottom.
They've got the silence out onto the Shadow Shaman. Is it enough, though? He's not dead just yet. They've got the arena as well as the spear that's going to land on Ollie. They get the kill on the GQ. The shards, though, it's not enough. It does put them away from this puck. They'll get the kill on Ollie. They'll look over at Kaka, trying to get a second with the Dream Coil placed down, and they should get two.
Just Blink Dagger and Shard, probably. Yep, he has both queued up. Shard is just a massive support.
Hex coming out, and they're going to look to get the stun to follow this up. They'll hold it as long as they
damage.
Can. Earth Splitter not even going to be needed. Or, well, actually, it gets the kill. Never mind. It's perfect time. Right
but
on the edge.
To say. Under the shadow of the Shadow Amulet.
They've got themselves
nice
the arena
spear.
As well as the spear that lands onto the puck. So they've got the Hex to follow it up. Emo dead again.
Absolutely ridiculous.
It really is. And they've got the Hex this time onto the Gyro. Can't get that Shadow Amulet off this time, but the Snowball will help him for a second. Call down used, and GQ, he's bitten off more than he can chew. They get the kill onto the Shadow Shaman. They'll chase after the Gyrocopter. Acid Spray down, and they end up trading one for one.
Nature's Prophet picks up. He gets Hexed immediately. Wow!
He's caught. They've got the Serpent Wards down, they've got the Shackle, and they should be able to get the damage, but he pops the BKB. Do they have it? One more shot? Oh, he just TP's out, and GQ again pays for it with his life.
And Mars also farming up the storm.
Fuels into the air, Gyro caught again, God's Rebuke hits, and he's right on the wall. The Snowball not in time
for Kaka.
Now he's put himself in the arena. So he's locked down as a contender in the arena, and he will lose his bout. Once he gets that shard, too. They're going to Blink Hit. They've got the Laurel's Punch as well as the Dream Coil. They should be able to get the kill into Faith Beyond. Orchid there. Nothing he can do but the Serpent Wards to turn this around. He's in the Acid Spray. They've got the Spear. They'll get the kill into JT. They'll look over as the Sloop lands onto Kaka. They'll hit him with God's Rebuke. The Essence Ring. He's trying to survive, but he's got nowhere to go. And a double kill for nothing to say as Ame focuses his attention onto Ollie.
Yeah, I hate fillers.
Dream Coil used, that's going to land on two of these heroes. It hits the Troll as well as the Alchemist. They're going to use the call down on top of it with the homing missile going after Ame. But they're not following this up. They've got the Shackle. Look at the Abyssal and the damage from Ame on the Emo.
He's like, come at me, bro. Come at me, Jack. Omni slash me. Please do it.
Oh, no,
JT. Oh, if he gets bashed up, he's gone.
Orchid.
Gone.
Oh, first hit. There it is. JT, he's gone. They've also maybe caught Kaka. Instead, they've caught themselves Flyfly. Never mind. They've got the Jug. They've got the Shackle as well as the Hex. They'll get that kill on a Flyfly. They've also slept Kaka. They'll chase. He'll try to TP, but the Abyssal's there. The kills come in, and LGD now lead 18k over IG.
SingQ looking for the profit here. And Kaka's
Kaka
getting going
on. Dream Coil. That's thrown down, but he can still take the tower. Meanwhile, bottom, ooh, they've got the
solo
catch.
Kill.
They should be able to get a kill. It's a solo kill on a JT. This troll is stunned up for a moment, and well, Faith Beyond, he'll stand in front. Take the aggression off of Ame as they'll look to get the bottom set of racks, and through this back door, can he get it? Looks like he should be likely to do so. Back door doesn't even mean anything. The door is kicked wide open. He's going to blink forward looking over for the gyrocopter. Emo trying to stop them in their tracks. They've got the arena down, but they're going to go back to base.
GG.
Call GG, and LGD will even the series up at one. A very easy, straightforward game for LGD.
Yeah, just... Laning phase should also be easier because it's not countered. And Emo on that hero can do a lot. Bottom, a lot of stacks.
Shackle. And the stacks are really starting to become a problem. They'll get first blood, they'll take out Ali, but the return kill is there. Earth Spike for Kaka to finish off Faith Beyond. A big bunch of creeps to go and take here for him. He's got to make sure that he doesn't allow the creep wave to really get denied out, but they've got three heroes up top. JT going in, looking over at the Clockwork, who've got the cogs around him. They've got the Hex onto JT. This is a problem now. Uzri Orb over. They've got the Dream Coil onto three. Well placed, but not in time to save JT. Emo's over. The Earth Spike misses. Especially if they're putting the pressure on bottom.
Goodbye.
Found the Shadow Shaman. And they will get the kill here on a Jinq. They're taking another tier one. The mid tier one still stands, but top and bottom looking like they're going to both fall.
A lot of poison damage.
Though, JT, a lot of damage being taken. They've got the Waning Rift. They'll hit the two-man stun from Kaka with the Dream Coil coming down. They get the kill on Innocence. They look over at Faith Beyond. Should be a second with the Cold Feet going over and freezing over this Viper.
Thank you, Shackle. Power shot.
Oh, power shot doing so much damage. Look at that. Kaka dropping. They've got the Chakra thrown over, trying to catch the Shadow Shot with the Waning Rift. They've got the Silence. They'll get the kill. They'll end up trading. Nothing to say, still standing nearby, and actually stays with Emo, who jaunts over to the Illusory Orb. The Shackle doesn't attach to JT, but they've got the Viper Strike onto the Timbersaw. They get the kill on Emo, and now they're going to be able to chase JT because he's so slowed up. They'll move forward if they can catch him from
getting
away.
On the high ground?
He's probably dead, but the Timber Chain doesn't bring him onto the low ground, so he's stuck on the high ground, pushed to the low ground via the cogs, and JT, he'll get run down. LGD.
Defuser blade.
Looking over mid. They've got the rod and they have thrown the hook shot over onto JT. He'll timber chain away, but the damage coming in is just too much for him to handle. Faith Beyond gets the kill. Bounty's being picked up by IG hook shot. That'll be thrown forward and they've got the Dream Coil down. Nothing to say in a lot of trouble. Pops the BKB. He is so quickly dispatched and now they're going to go after Faith Beyond. You see that Fly gets involved the second he's got the defuser blade. He'll get the kill on Faith Beyond and they'll look over to take the tier one over mid. Thorns anywhere are really a pain. Hook shot, and they're going to set up the cogs with the Hex. Ice Blast coming in, but they've got the Shackle with the Serpent Wards. It's locked down enough to get the kill here on Emo. Ali in an interesting spot as the Earth Spike's thrown over onto Innocence. They lock up that Clockwork for a second. They've got the Hex onto the Shadow Shaman. Jinq again found in a pretty poor spot as Innocence falls to Fly finger used. Jinq gone, two heroes dead on the side of LGD. Onto the high ground. Innocence will be the one who breaks the smoke, uses that rocket flare, scouts them out. Well done there by this Clockwork, who throws down the cogs. That's actually going to push over Emo, who's going to have his Lincolns broken. The Serpent Wards are on the funnel spot of these stairs. They'll use the finger. They'll look over to get the kill on Innocence. They'll take out one. He's going to buy back immediately. They're looking over his Faith Beyond, trying to run with the Ice Blast coming in. And
huge
that
Ice
will
Blast.
Land. Shackle, I think, bounce back and hit nothing to say and attach them to a tree, but they've got themselves the Shackle, the Commitment onto the Phantom Lancer. Will they get the kill with the Battle Trance being used nearby? Ame, they've got the Lotus Orb on him, but it's not going to help him. Fly is gone. They look over at JT. They have locked up his Timber. He's got nothing to do here except rattle around as the Battery Assault hits him. He'll walk away from a distance, but still pretty slow. Not going to matter. They can't catch up to him. They are going to look for the fight, though. They are smoked up. They'll look over mid. They'll use that Dream Coil. They've got the Ice Blast coming over, and that should hit onto the Shadow Shaman. He just sidesteps it. They find themselves a stun out onto the Windrunner. The Phantom Lancer trying to fight man fight over onto Ame. They've got the BKB Popeye. Nothing to say. They go after Kaka. He's going to chase this line, get the kill. He's now dominating. They've finished off a trade, though, on Jinq, who is low to start the fight. Flamethrower. Is it enough here from JT? He's all by himself. He'll timber chain into some distance, trying to TP out and will be successful. It's a 2-for-1 as they lose both their supports on IG. That was a fight that they took. Ooh, nothing to say. Spots Emo.
He canceled the blink?
Yeah, he did cancel the blink, but they don't follow it up.
Nothing happening.
Broken Clock is right twice a day, though. Earth Spike comes in, Rod of Atos, as well as the Shackle being used. The Ice Blast is going to come over to the Clock, but they've got the damage coming in from Nothing to Say to rip off Kaka and Ollie immediately. Hookshot was used with the jetpack away, and this could be a big fight for IG on the fact that they're on the opposite side of the map. They're near the objective.
Yeah, the Clock.
They've got the Hex to look over. They're going to catch Flyfly. They've got the Shackle, the Lotus Orb is on him. They've stunned out the Windrunner, though. They get the kill over on a Jinq. They've taken out one. He doesn't have buyback. He's dead for 62 seconds with the Air Spike hitting onto the Clockwork. Now they're starting to put the pressure on the side of LGD. They've got the Viper Strike thrown over onto JT with a Waning Rift that's going to silence up this Troll. Troll trying to do all he can. He goes into the Battle Trance, and now he's going to fight this Phantom Lancer. They've got the Shackle. Isn't enough. The damage coming in. He's got the Lotus Orb. Will he survive? He goes into the Doppelganger trying to run away. The Illusions is going to be enough for him.
Buyback.
It's looking likely that he can turn this around because Ami's going to fall. Nothing to Say trying to salvage the fight. He looks over as the Shackle doesn't connect anything, but he's got the damage to take out Flyfly. Jetpack into the air. They don't have buyback on Ami. He's going to be dead for 95 seconds. They'll take out Kaka. That's going to be another one dead on the side of IG. Both these heroes have buyback on the side of IG, so let's see if they use it as they'll chase JT. Nothing to Say salvages the fight, and they will commit the buyback. Phantom Lancer will buyback. I think they're recognizing the fact that Troll doesn't have his own buyback. They'll use the hookshot. They're right on top of JT, and they'll get the kill onto this Timber. But right on in is Emo. He's going to boots travel in, look over at Innocence, whose jetpack runs out of fuel. Emo, Waning Rift, don't think he saw him. Silenced? Hiding? No way!
Oh, man. It was a questionable decision to begin with. Oh, Jinq is still ready here to jump in, perhaps.
Oh, Nothing to Say. He wants to go for it. They're going to try and get Roach. The Roach is down. He just picked up my Flyfly. They're going to go over on the JT. They've got the Ice Blast coming out of the Troll. Is he with the Ice Blast? He's going to be dead. Ami's gone for 99 seconds without buyback. IG might have just taken this game away from the hands of LGD. And they've got Nothing to Say. They'll get the kill. Down he goes. Four heroes dead on the side of LGD. IG lose nothing. Another Toxin down. Not sure they're going to be willing to fight, but they've got the Hex coming through as well as the Dream Code that's going to be used onto the Shadow Summon. They've got the Silence off of the Clockwork. They're going to bring Ame in to try and make something happen, but they've already lost Jinq. Jinq gone for a long time as they'll go out on Kaka. Kaka will fall, but he gets a finger out before he dies as well as an Earth Spike. Hookshot comes in. Innocent's gone. Two heroes in on the side of LGD. They're trying to defend, but it's not defending well.
Aegis still up there.
Diffusal used as well as the Invisible Blade. That comes out onto Ame. They've got the Silence as well as the Hex. They'll use the Finger. They've got the Dream Core. They're going to drop down all this damage. The Ice Blast lands. He's going to be dead. He'll have buyback, so they have a second chance here with Ame. Lotus Orb on the Timber. JT trying to get out, but the hook shot as he tries the Timber Chain away. Well timed by Innocence. JT falls. Kaka's dead without buyback. They're going to try and go. They might be able to find Flyfly. They're right on him.
On the
Hex. Do they have it? Phantom Lancer, he's out, he's too far, he's gone. Oh no, Flyfly, 2 minutes. He's got buyback, but that is a big kill. If they could force his buyback, that is a win condition for LGD. They'll look over at the Ancient Apparition while they'll also find the Lion. Can they get the kill here? He's used that Ghost Scepter. Ollie dies, Kaka falls, they all have buyback. JT
first
trying to TP out. LGD have found a way to get four kills and clean up the side of IG. Right into the triangle, they're smoked up. They're nearby. They're into Roche. Oh, Emo spots him. Dream Coil used, and that's with the Ags, but this is an early Dream Coil. Now they're gonna look over
at
Innocence. They've got the Finger as well as the Air Spike coming in, and the Ice Blast lands out of the Viper as well as the Troll. They're gonna try and run away. The Viper, the Dream Coil, finally not there on him, but with the BKB popping, Nothing to Say, they need to find their attention onto the right heroes. The Phantom Lancer's into the back line.
Yes,
they get the beyond, but they've got the Shackle as well as the Serpent Wards. The Silence is gonna stop these Shackles from holding down Flyfly, but the damage coming in, they've got enough to get that kill. He's got buyback, but three heroes already dead on the side of OGD, and I'm not sure Ame can continue to withstand the onslaught that's coming in from IG. They look over, they've got the Dag, and they'll get the kill. He's gone for 2 minutes. They'll take out the Ancient Apparition. It's just Nothing to Say here. Up against the world, IG are chasing. They're looking to get the kill. They've silenced him up, but they can't control him enough. Oh, look at the damage come out immediately onto the Troll, looking with that Dagon as well as the Waning Rift. These silences, this damage from the pop has just been too much for them to handle. They go to the club near the Manta, gets popped. He's broken on the Nether Toxin. Innocence looking for his opportunity to jump in, but they've got the Hex. They'll have the Ice Blast coming through, and it looks like they're going to get the kill to the Clockwork with a Finger. Can he get away on this one? The visitor tension on the emo. They got a kill out of the puck. They taking him out. He's going to buy back immediately. Now they'll go over to Chase. He's going to man the front lines, trying to do something here as he looks over at Ame. He's got him under the flamethrower, and Emo's back into the fight. He's right back here, but they get the battle trance off. They've got the stun with the BKB being popped. Looking over
at the Windrunner.
Throws the shackle shot with the Lotus Orb. It bounces off back over onto the Windrunner. So nothing to say. He needs to back off for a second with Troll trying to survive this, but he's getting low. He's going to freeze over to the cold feed. He'll end up dying. He does have buyback as well. So he's buyback. But you've got yourself Innocence, who's out of the fight, 95 seconds without buyback. They'll look over as JT will timber chain away, and I think this gives them the opportunity to go towards tier fives.
Still cheese on Phantom Lancer, now used, back to full health. Age is still online. Emo has to be a little bit careful here. But as you said, it's going to be a 4v5 fight if they choose to fight this. Tier 5 items in 30 seconds. They want to go Mega Creeps.
They want to go Megas. They want to at least have that locked down. They've got Flyfly manning the front lines. We've seen how quickly they can blow up these heroes with the Ice Blast as well as the Dagon, the finger combinations coming through. This is tough.
Lotus Orb.
Reflected. Earth Spike coming in. There's the finger. There's the kill. Faith Beyond is gone, but so is Kaka. They both have buyback. They're going to be back into the fight immediately. JT's going to be able with that Ghost Scepter, and now he needs to worry about how far he's going in. He's going to Timber Chain all the way to the back of this base, and he's in too far. He's Timber Chain too deep. He's going to be dead again. They've got themselves Megas, so all that sacrifice just to get Megas. They look over. Nothing to say. He's taking a lot of damage. So the Nova Fire comes in. Is it going to be enough to get the kill on another? To say they've got the Hex coming out of the Phantom Lancer. They've got the fucking Fire used out of the Phantom Lancer as well. Flyfly trying to turn this around. He'll go after him with the Abyssal Blade. They've got the Earth Spike getting out of the Shadow Shaman, but they've got the damage coming out of the Flyfly with the Nova Fire on him. He gets the Double Ganger out of the high ground. They look to the back lines. They've got themselves a Pirate Hat all of a sudden. He's going to wear that cap and try to turn this around on the side of LGT. They get the kill on the GQ. They look over and nothing to say. They've got the figure that hits it. Kaka gets the kill and nothing to say. He'll buy back. But Kaka, he's gone. Oh, the Crypt is out of here. IG get the game. They get the
Wow, I think I didn't
GG is there.